This screencast will apply the fundamentals learned in Chapter 1, Introduction to Aspen Plus, to an industrial-relevant chemical process. The goal of this project is to design a chlorobenzene production plant that produces greater than 95 mole percent monochlorobenzene and greater than 80 mole percent paradichlorobenzene through the direct chlorination of benzene. At this point, pause the video and take a moment to review the given feed parameters. Caustic solution is available at the specified conditions to remove impurities from the products. The core of the process involves a reactor, where benzene and chlorine gas are reacted according to the previous reaction shown. The reaction occurs in two phases with a vapor draw-off. The liquid effluent moves on to a washer unit, where the remaining hydrogen chloride is reacted with caustic solution in a neutralization reaction and removed in a waste stream. From the washer, the process stream moves into a benzene separator, where unreacted benzene is drawn off the top and can be used as a potential recycle source. The bottom's product moves on to a chlorobenzene separator, which separates the two chlorobenzene products. To begin, open Aspen Plus software and create a new simulation with metric units. Input the process components: benzene, chlorine, monochlorobenzene, paradichlorobenzene, sodium hydroxide, sodium chloride, water, and hydrogen chloride. Click on the green next arrow to move on. Choose the RK swap method, as we will be working with mainly nonpolar hydrocarbon components that do not follow ideal behavior. Press the green next arrow and run the property analysis. You will notice that a warning is issued on the sodium hydroxide Antoine parameters. This will not affect our simulation because we will not be working with sodium hydroxide in the vapor phase. Press the green arrow once more and go to the simulation environment. Save your file where it can be accessed later. Watch the following tutorial screencasts in Chapter 2, Reactors, to continue the series.